Hey y'all, Blind Magic here, and we're back with Mega Man Anniversary Collection. This is part 3 of Mega Man 7. Last time we defeated 4 more Robot Masters, and this time we're going to defeat the last one and take the fight to Wily. But before we do that, let's visit the shop real quick by pressing select, or whatever your controller's equivalent is. We find this giant Eddie that actually houses a shop run by Eddie and Otto. Hey! That's my bolt! Thanks! It fits perfectly! Now I can work at full power! Look, a new item just for you. I can now make items using half the normal number of bolts. Select the item you want made. So yeah, you can buy 1-ups, E-tanks, weapon tanks. You can buy the exit module if you didn't find it. Not worth it. You can buy beat whistles. We haven't unlocked beat, so we can't buy this yet. You can buy the S-tank, which replaces the M-tank from the previous games. It just refills your life and all of your weapons. You can buy the rush jet adapter if you didn't want to find it. You can buy the rush search if you didn't want to find it. The energy balancer. And as you might guess, this hyper rocket buster is also something we can find that I am definitely not spending 800 bolts on. The shop mainly useful for getting your tanks and lives, and if you need to get more beat whistles. But we're not going to spend anything right now. We're just going to head on into the last Robot Master stage, Turbo Man. His stage is kind of annoying, not going to lie. Right off the bat, I'm going to equip the super adapter and start charging it. And we are going to be chased all the way to the end of the screen by this Joe and his spiky bulldozer. But a couple hits with the super adapter takes him out pretty handily. Then we got these cones that are only vulnerable while they're in the air. Another Joe. Yo, Joe! So these tires are kind of annoying. They bounce you backward if you jump into them. And those are spikes down there. This is where the rush adapter becomes very useful. We don't want to fall down the center of these tires, which is a hole. It'll lead us to the bottom screen. And we'll have to climb back up. Well, I guess that guy's gonna live. This is where we want to rush search. Look familiar? It's the Hyper Rocket Punch, which gives our Rocket Punch significantly more range, and better tracking, too. Anyway, we can go off to the right here. Mega Man, Have you collected the R, U, S, and H circuit plates? Cool. But remember, the Super Mega Man armor is too bulky to allow you to slide. Good luck, Mega Man. I'll see you later, if you survive. Alright, with that, we can head on. Yeah, speaking of sliding... These do not kill you instantly, but they do a lot of damage. These, however, do kill you instantly! Good old quick lasers, huh? That E-Tank is a trap. Don't go for it. It's super not worth it. And that brings us to the Sissy Truck, which is actually weak to Thunder. But we can just Mega Buster it just as well. Well, maybe not. Okay, I guess I'll switch to the Thunder then. All in all, that quick laser section is not as difficult as Quick Man's actual stage. I guess it does go down a lot faster when you use the proper weapon. Might as well pick up the health drop. And here we are at Turbo Man. And we're gonna start... Oop, that is the wrong weapon. Start by avoiding that garbage. So I'm gonna have to be quiet for this because I need to listen for a sound cue when he goes in car mode. When he revs his engine, that's how you know he's about to actually drive. Because it is random how long he does that. You'll hear him do a burnout, but it's once you hear the engine rev, that's when he's about to drive. The Scorch Wheel launches a flaming wheel, right? Yes, and the wheel may also burn the things it touches. Like the forest? You get Scorch Wheel! Dr. Light, what happened? Is that you, Mega Man? Bass went berserk after I completed his repairs. He stole the parts for the new enhancements. Bass! I can't believe it! Believe it, Mega Man! Bass and Treble are my creations. I knew that you would be stupid enough to trust him and allow him access to the lab. Now, Bass and Treble will use the enhancements meant for you and Rush. Ha 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 ha. I'll make you pay, Wily. And that gives us access to the Wily stages, but we've got a couple stages to revisit before we do that. We need to get back past the T-Rex in Slash Man stage. I hate that it's all the way at the end. I really wish I had Turbo Man's weapon before coming here, but he's a difficult fight without the weakness, and I don't like to fight it. Well, we should have an easier time with the T-Rex, at least. Area. We could just start setting the forest on fire. Turbo Man is such a good influence. I do love how the boa constrictors get their faces burnt. The last one reveals a ladder. We find poor Beep trapped in a cage. Charge Shot will free him. And that will give us access to the Beep Call. As you see, we have four of them. What Beep does is he will rescue you when you fall in a pit. If you run out, you will have to buy more. But he will pull you up and you'll be floating over the pit for a brief time, and you can't control Beep. And basically what you want to do is move him to a position where you're safe, or he'll just drop you right back in the pit. And we also need to go revisit Shade Man. There will be no Ghosts and Goblins music this time. I'm gonna still collect this bolt though. And we want to get back to the pumpkin boss, because that is where our next path lies. I'll just go underneath it this time. I think it's still got the same weakness on the inside as it does the out, which is the Thunderbolt. So we wait for it to do two small bounces. And then it will, on the third bounce, it will do a big one that we can slide under. Do enough damage, and it will destroy the floor on the left side of the room. Enabling us to take the second path. And we want to switch to... Actually, I think I'm going to switch to the super adapter. I'll see how this goes. Normally I do it with the Mega Buster, but this might work better. Uh-oh. I missed something. What did I miss? Oh my goodness. I don't remember what I missed. Okay, I didn't actually miss anything, but what I failed to realize is when I exited, or when I turned off the game, I should say, and resumed, it didn't keep track of the fact that I visited Proto Man and Cloud Man's stage. You have to visit Proto Man and Turbo Man's stage and Cloud Man's stage to get this. So I will quickly visit Proto Man and we will meet you back at that door. And we're back. So I revisited Proto Man in Cloud Man stage. And I haven't turned it off since we did Turbo Man stage, so this should work now. So, brother, you are not as weak as I thought. Let's see which of us father made stronger. Yep. So, we have to fight Proto Man. And as you might have guessed, he's not the easiest thing. Probably easier to do it with the Mega Buster. Unfortunately, we have to fight this guy every time we fail. So I will probably use E-Tanks if I need to. Let's try this again. Strategies are not too different than they are from Mega Man 3, although he does have a couple of extra attacks that he didn't have then, like his ability to charge his Proto Buster. Don't want to shoot him when his shield's out. It does appear that he is weak to the Mega Buster. since he does actually get kind of stunned by it. Seems like he's firing faster now. He got me. Again. Ugh. You know what, Sharmo? Cut off this. And we're back. I just paid a revisit to Cloudman's stage to see Protoman there once again, since it didn't keep track of it after I shut off the game. And this is still the same recording session as when I saw him in Turbo Man stage, so we should be good now. So, brother, you're not as weak as I thought. Let's see which of us father made stronger. That's right, Protoman wants to attack us. And his attack strategy is not too different from how it was in Mega Man 3. Except he does this shield dash, and he can charge up his buster. And on his third jump, he will shoot a spray. He does appear to be weak to the Mega Buster, since he gets stunned by it. I would honestly suggest just every time you hit him with the Mega Buster, just be ready to jump over him and immediately fire. He'll either block it and charge up his buster, or he'll start shooting, at which point you can actually attack him. And try to hit him with charge shot after his first jump. Eventually, he'll go down. But that's a lot of lather, rinse, repeat of a fight. There we go. Maybe you are the superior model, Mega Man. Here, take this with you. This is your proto-shield. You can't give this to me. It's okay. Take it. And watch your back. So yes, we get the proto-shield. With the proto-shield equipped, we have a shield in front of us when we're standing still. It does not protect us when we jump or move or slide, but we do still have all of our functionality. It also doesn't protect us when we're actually shooting. So this is effectively our new base Mega Man state, because there's no reason not to ever equip the proto-shield over regular Mega Man. But with that, let us hit the exit. And I'm gonna hit the shop real quick. You can hit the top button on our controller to skip the cutscene. I want to buy a couple of weapon tanks. Just two. We don't have very many bolts, and the weapon tanks are kind of expensive. And let's head to the Wily stage. Like most Wily stages, we're just going to see a lot of gimmicks that we've seen previously. It is worth noting that you will still see bolts that you can pick up in these stages, because you can actually visit the shop in between stages. So, these platforms here, not my favorite, but if we use the super adapter, we can kind of trivialize them. While you're standing on it, the lights go out. When they hit a break in the platform, they start spinning, which makes them impossible to stand on, as you might have guessed. I don't know why I was trying to get that weapon energy. Here we have panels on the floor that when you stand on them, the lights go out. I think I want that. I can't reach it like this. Oh well. Not the end of the world. Might as well just wait until this guy... does what he's gonna do. And we're definitely gonna equip our super adapter again. Because we got these platforms again, except now, over a bottomless pit. And you kind of just want to bunny hop here so you can actually see what you're doing. Luckily, it's not too bad with the super adapter equipped, but it is kind of atrocious if you don't have it equipped. This screen's not too fun either, but definitely don't want to make that jump at the top of your jump. Why am I even going for this? I don't need this. I think I want Super Adapter equipped here. You are far too weak, Mega Man. Wily may fear you, but I do not. So base is weak to the Super Adapter. And his arena here doesn't do him any favors. Round one goes to you, Mega Man, but I'll be back. We'll take the free guy, sure. And that leads us to our boss. Who is our boss? It is... Oh, Gutsman. He's weak to the Slash Claw. Yeah, I'm not quite sure how to avoid taking damage from that. I think I am gonna burn the E-Tank though. Because that attack hurts, and I don't know how to avoid it. It deals a lot more damage to him if you can launch a block into him than it does to attack him directly with the Slash Claw. That does it! This episode might end up being a little bit short, but I think I am going to call it here. So, if you enjoyed the video, please subscribe to see more, smash that like button, and leave me a comment. I am PlowMajor, this has been Mega Man Anniversary Collection, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!